Welcome back.
Oh my God.
You look great. You smell great.
Thank you.
Are you wearing a cologne?
You know, I just put in a Halls.
Ah! That's what I was getting, a little menthol.
Yeah, right, a little menthol.
A little menthol, I can breathe better. Yeah.
Yeah.
By just talking to you. It's always good to see you. You're one of the best to ever do it. Not only, by the way, are you in one of the biggest shows on Broadway, but also, you're in the top three of the cast albums on the Billboard charts.
Wow.
Look at that. Hamilton.
So cool.
Two of the top three.
Is you. That's insane.
What would little Jonathan Groff say about this?
Little Jonathan Groff.
Little Peter Pan Jonathan Groff.
Oh my gosh. That's the Strasbourg Halloween Parade, which my family still does every year.
What is that?
It's where this last year they did, Barbie was the theme of the parade. It's very competitive in my hometown,
Oh, yeah. The
Halloween Parade. And so my brother and his family are still there. That year, we won with Peter Pan, obviously.
So everyone competes and does a float.
Thank you.
How long were you suspended for the whole?
I was suspended for several hours.
Okay.
I really remember it. It was like the best. I remember the fairy dust that I was throwing out. We went to Disney World the next day.
Isn't that wild?
Yeah, yeah.
Did you know that you wanted to act and do all the stuff then?
Yeah, my parents let me dress up like Peter Pan and Mary Poppins and running through the fields of Pennsylvania. Yeah, always knew.
And now here you are, and merrily we roll along. It's a giant buzz over this. This is insane. You're in two of the top three cast albums.
Crazy.
Did you ever expect this type of success?
No, never. I never dreamt this big. And this show is about a group of friends that lived in New York for 20 years, and we start the show at the end and go back to the beginning. So I start the show at 40 and end at 20 years old. And I've lived in New York now for about 20 years, and so there's something for all of us working on this show that feels super personal. And because it goes back to the beginning of the story at the end, and we end at 20 years old, we end with this energy that you have when you first move to New York
Yeah.
and are excited and full of dreams. And so it's
such a clever idea for a play, because when you're in your 20s, who knows what the future is, but you're like, we're gonna be best friends forever.
Totally,
and
yes.
Then, you know, life happens.
We are gonna be best friends forever, right?
We are, this isn't a play.
Yeah,
this isn't a play, this is real life.
Yeah,
we're besties.
Yeah.
Yeah, are you kidding me?
Okay.
Oh, absolutely. Can I quickly just talk about your dressing room?
You have
this plugged in in your dressing room. This is Barbara.
Yes.
Now,
thank you, Sass Goldberg, for making that neon sign. So Barbara Streisand.
Hello, come on. Yes.
This is crazy. There's a lot of connectivity here.
There is.
Because on April 5th, 1961, 63 years ago, Barbara Streisand made her television debut on The Tonight Show that at that time was being shot at the Hudson Theater.
Whoa.
Where Merrily We Roll Along is.
Wow.
She was 19 years old. She made her TV debut. She sang a song called A Sleep and Be. If you can't tell, I'm obsessed with Barbara Streisand.
Yeah.
I made this sign in my dressing room.
So you have like people back and have drinks?
Barbara, yeah.
After the show?
In honor of Barbara Streisand, that's how she spells her name, that I turned my dressing room into a bar. We've had the divas. We've had Sutton Foster and Patti LuPone and Glenn Close and a bottle of champagne back.
No.
Yes, the ultimate being.
Has Barbara ever?
She hasn't been yet, although Meryl Streep came, blessed us with her presence at the show. Yes! And Meryl, so Meryl came into the dressing room.
Yes.
She came into Barbara, and I was like, Meryl's in Barbara. Like, I can't believe this is happening. And she took out her phone, and she was like, Jonathan, will you sit on the couch there that you have in front of the sign? And I was like, sure. So I, like, sat and, like, was smiling because I thought Meryl was taking a picture of me in front of Barbara. And then she was like, okay, all right, Barbara, so this is Jonathan Groff, and he's in Merrily We Roll Along, and this is the sign that he's made, and here we are in his dressing room. And I...
She texted.
Was like.
Barbara Streisand knows who you are.
I died.
That's cool.
I died.
That's cool.
I made a video for Barbara. I died 1,000 gay deaths.
That is fantastic.
Yeah.
There's a scene in the play where you type something on a typewriter for Daniel Radcliffe.
Yes, yes.
And no one ever sees what you type.
Yes.
What is it that you type?
Yeah, this is like a little insight. If you come and see Merrily We Roll Along, it's in the song Opening Doors. Lindsay Mendez and Dan Radcliffe and I are singing this song together. It's very fast. He leaves for a split second, and I run over as the character of Frank and type a little message to him. And it's always obscene, obviously, and unmentionable. It's always unmentionable.
To make him laugh?
To make him laugh, to make him mess up, whatever. Just to try and, like, poke him a little.
Yeah, keep it fun.
Yeah, keep it fresh,
keep it fun. Yes. Why not? So it changes all the time.
It's usually obscene, but then we started auctioning off the piece of paper, because right now every Broadway show is collecting for an amazing organization called Broadway Cares Equity Fights AIDS.
Oh, yeah.
Amazing charity.
Absolutely.
And so now I've had to roll back on the obscenities and type something palatable to auction off at the end of every show.
Yeah, I've done stuff for Broadway Cares.
You have?
Yes, I have.
They do amazing work. Amazing work.
Amazing. Well, I thought it might be kind of interesting. We have a typewriter here. What do you think? You think that maybe...
You just happen to have that typewriter there?
Yeah, we always have it, just in case. This has been here since Jack Parr. Barbara Streisand. Barbara Streisand used to type all of her songs on this typewriter.
Yeah. What?
Yeah. It's another weird coincidence.
Oh my God. Okay. Thought.
Uh-huh.
April 5th is the anniversary of Barbara Streisand making her television debut on the Hudson Theater stage.
Don't have to tell me.
I mean, yeah. Now we all know.
Yeah, I agree.
If I type something on this typewriter, will you also type something and or sign something? And we can auction it off on April 5th, the anniversary of Barbara Streisand's television appearance?
Yes, absolutely. I love it.
You will?
Yes, I have to do it.
Oh, my God.
All right, what are we typing?
Okay. I'll start a sentence, and you can finish it.
All right, done. Okay, done, yeah. And then, yeah. Okay. It says, I love. Tom Cruise. I put, I love New York City.
Oh, that's great.
And I think that's
beautiful.
That was good, right? We did this together. Did we sign it?
Yes.
How do we do it? How do you take it out? Do you know how to take it out? Whoa.
Oh, my God. Thanks, Jimmy.
Oh, we have to do this. Come on. I've never seen your signature.
Wow. Nice.
There it is right there, folks. I really wrote a big signature.
It's really good.
I wrote a giant signature. Congrats on the show. Congrats. Best of luck in the rest of the run. Jonathan Groff, Merrily We Roll Along is playing now on Broadway at the Hudson Theater. Jonathan and I are doing something fun after the break. Stick around. Hey, hey.